Hi, Danica here, and in this video, we are still gonna check out HighLevel, which is an all-in-one sales and marketing platform. In the last video, we have checked out how the backend works, the dashboard looks, and the different sections and features that you can use for your WordPress website. Now, in this video, we are gonna dive in and check out how you could integrate and use HighLevel for your WordPress membership site, which I've also used for our projects before. So, let's get started. This video is sponsored by HighLevel, an all-in-one sales and marketing platform, and I'm very excited to share you what it can do for your WordPress site since I've personally used it for our projects before. Thanks HighLevel for sponsoring this video. So in the last video, I have showed you how we could integrate HighLevel for your WordPress site and also showed you another way for how you could use it with WP Fusion, which is one of the applications that I use for building WordPress membership sites. So in this video, we are going to focus on that. So just like in my last video where I've showed you how to connect WP Fusion to your CRM, the process should be exactly similar. And once you have connected it, it should look like this. You could see that I have in here assigned tags that will be added once the user is created from the WordPress site. You could also see that I've assigned a band tag, which is from HighLevel that I created. And of course, the custom field that I created in HighLevel to store the password so that I could email the members their login credentials. I also prepared some tags here for membership level that I'm going to show you how to use for your WordPress membership site and protect access. So here, as you can see, I have free access, so WordPress free access tag, WordPress paid access tag, and the other tags that we're using with WP Fusion. You could also see in the custom fields that I have here the WordPress password field that I'm using in here. Now, if you have integrated the two and you can't find the tags or field, try to reload or refresh the available tags and fields using this button, or try clearing your cache. So far, it fixed the issue whenever I encounter that kind of problem. So let's test this out now. So I have this page in here. First is I have a login page and I have a login form with Elementor. And if I go back, I also created this register for free form, which is also an Elementor Pro form and is integrated with HighLevel via WP Fusion. Now, if you're wondering how to integrate the form to HighLevel with WP Fusion, check out the last video because in there I have showed how to attach a tag to your form so that it could send the contact details directly to your account. So here, I'm gonna add my details. So I'm just gonna do first name and of course, an email. And then register. For this one, it should redirect to my thank you page. Now, if I go back to my HighLevel account, under automation, I have used the tag associated in this automation. So the tag was WordPress trigger create access. So if I go back to my register form, you can see under the WP Fusion that that is the tag that I'm using in here. So WordPress trigger create access, which is also the one used in this automation workflow. So here's the contact that I just registered to get the free access. So if I click this, you could see that. So I have my email, and then at the bottom, there is my password generated with HighLevel via WP Fusion. You could also see that the WordPress free access tag is applied because we have that in our automation here that after they enter the automation, we remove the trigger tag and we apply the free access tag. There's also a webhook, and as you can see, there's one contact here waiting for 1 minute. If we check that out, it should be our contact. So let's check under status. So that was our contact, and it says here finished. So let's check our email. So here's the email that I receive, my username and password. This password should be exactly similar to what we have stored in here. Now, do note that for security reason, this is just temporary. What I want you to do is to encourage your members to reset their password. So maybe in your email, indicate that it's a temporary password and ask them, as they're part of their onboarding process, to reset it so that you don't have their password in here. Now that I have that login credentials generated, I'm going to try to log in and see how it works. So I'm going to go here and I'm going to copy and paste those credentials that I received. So log in. And now you can see that I am redirected to a dashboard page, which is what I have set. So we have two sections here. It says free access and the other one says paid access. I haven't configured this page yet, so we need to set this up in WP Fusion so it shows the correct content based on our tag. I'm also gonna try to hide this link when they are logged in. So first, let's hide this registration link once they are logged in. So click that button. I'm in my header template right now. And as you can see, WP Fusion is in here. So we just need to say visibility should be for logout user only. So I'm going to hit the update button and let's see how that looks. So now the registration button is gone and let's proceed to protecting the sections properly. Okay, so I'm in the dashboard right now and what I want to do is I want to protect the section for those who has the free tag and then the section for those who has the paid tag. So to do that, edit your page with Elementor and under advanced, there should be WP Fusion and in here, we could say what high level tag we want to require. So for the paid access, we want to call or only show that if they have the paid access tag. Well, for the free access, we could say in WP Fusion, we want to make sure they have the free access and they don't have the paid access. So I'm gonna click update and see how it looks. So I'm in my members view right now. And if I'm gonna reload the page, you can see that I only have this free access section in my dashboard because I don't have the paid tag. That's why. So this is now working and is protected with the high level tag via WP Fusion. Now, how about if we have the paid tag? Since in our rule here, we say they must have the free access tag, but they should not have the paid access tag. So example, if we go to our contact in WP Fusion and apply the paid access tag right away here, we don't need to do anything, that's automatically saved. And I'm gonna go to our WordPress site and I'm just gonna make sure this is synchronized. Now, in your workflow, you should run the update webhook so that this is automated. But in this demonstration, I'm just gonna manually update the website. I'm also just gonna open that user account and resync the tag because again, we didn't run the update webhook of WP Fusion in our high level account. So I needed to do this manually. But if you set up the webhook in your automation, you don't need to do this manually. So as you can see, I now have the free and paid access. So let's test if this is working. So on your website here, you can see that we now have the paid access. So from free access, based on the rule that we set, we are now converted to paid access because we have the high level tag assigned properly. Another thing that I'm going to test is I'm just going to remove this paid access tag. And by doing that, it is also removed here in high level. Now, what I want to try is, example, if I create a new page and say paid access only, and I want to protect that page with that paid access tag assigned here. So you need to go on the sidebar, check the user must be logged in so that you could assign the tag. And I'm gonna publish these changes. Now, since our login account doesn't have the paid access after we remove it, if we test this, and let's say I'm gonna enter that URL, you could see that it says, oops, you don't have a permission to view this page. Make sure you're logged in and try again or contact support. Now, that message is coming from the setup in WP Fusion, which is this one. So if I edit that page and let's say I'm gonna do text like members view only. So this is the content, right? And then if I update, since this page is protected with the WordPress paid access tag, those contacts who does not have the right tag when they're logged in can't see your content, so it's protected. So it still says oops. Now how about if we add the paid access tag back? So if we edit the tags here and we apply the paid access tag again and click the update user button, we should have that tag now. And if we reload the page from this message, it should change to members view only. So the content is now showing. So this is how you could use HighLevel to your WordPress membership site. And in this demonstration, we're using HighLevel with the plugin WP Fusion. And you can see that you could protect your content properly via the tag and show the specific content based on their membership level. Now, how could you use this for your automation? So let's just say you create a products under the payment section in your HighLevel account. And then with that product, you create an automation workflow. You assign a specific tag when they purchase, and then you generate their access to your WordPress membership site. So if they don't have the correct tag, then you could show maybe a free version or a trial, depending on your offer to your members. And because we're using HighLevel with WP Fusion, there's a lot of more things that we could do, like set up GamePress with it or integrate LearnDash with it, because we're using the tag-based protection via HighLevel with the help of WP Fusion. So I hope this video helps and you saw how powerful it is to use your HighLevel CRM for your WordPress membership site with the help of WP Fusion. If you have any question regarding the setup, please comment it down below and I'll do my best to answer your question as soon as I can, or maybe create a separate video to answer those questions. Again, if you're interested to learn how HighLevel could help your business and use it for your WordPress site or else for your WordPress membership site, I'm gonna include my link below so that you could sign up for their 14-day free trial to test out their platform. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.